Hello everyone, I'm Frederick Knutson, aka 4th Oracle. Let's watch some Gigantic. So this is a scrim between ApeX and ETA. ETA is a newer team, ApeX is a bit more venerable. They've been around since Alpha, but ETA in this game gives them quite a run for their money. So first up, let's look at the team compositions. They're very similar. They both have a Sven, they both have a Wu, and they both have a Beckett. So Sven is a really obvious choice for Siren Strand because it allows your entire team to get up to the center point without any upgrades. It's just always available from the start. So really obvious there. Wu is another common pick for Siren Strand because he has Splash Kick that can let him get up to that center point as well. Plus, vertical mobility on Siren Strand in general is really strong. There are a lot of places where you can use it. Then you have Beckett. Both teams picked Beckett, and I think that's really important to note because when you look at Beckett, you want to ask, why am I not picking Charnock here? And here I think it's because when Charnock uses Detonate, like let's suppose Beckett and Charnock both want to get up to the center point. When Charnock detonates and gets up there, he now is not getting any more utility from Detonate. Beckett, on the other hand, after she jetpacks up, she's still getting utility. She does the double jump, she immediately lands, and she can start double jumping again. So she still is using that jetpack. So the differences in these teams are really important to note too, though. For your beefier frontliner, ApeX has Poco, whereas ETA has HK. So Poco is kind of a natural pick for Siren Strand, I think. Yeah, I know it makes sense. He's basically a Wampa, and he likes the caves, but there are a lot of really narrow areas that his breath is really strong in, allows him to close distance really easily. HK, on the other hand, like even though he can't take advantage of those narrow passageways as easily, he's really strong in that center point in pre-clash. He's strong post-clash too on Siren Strand, but especially up on the ledge up by the portraits. If he can get up to that ledge, then he's in a very, very strong position and can command some real zoning potential there. The other difference is ApeX is running Voden, and ETA is running Trip. So the double assassin is pretty strong on Siren Strand there. It's really easy for an assassin to move around quickly. Voden, however, is an interesting choice. I think that the reason they picked him in part was for that healing spring. Obviously, he's still very strong in Siren Strand because Voden likes medium range, and Siren Strand is composed almost entirely of medium range engagements. But also, he has the hidden spring. He can upgrade that to essentially serve a similar function as Elastic Ooze. Either way, let's get this underway because this match is fairly long and pretty exciting. And play. So they're Orion, not that they matter much. So the opening for this map is always extremely important because the first minute or so decides pretty much how the game is going to be going from that point on. So ApeX in this game, they want D, but I think that their team composition is more willing to give it up because they have a little bit more ability. Like I was saying, they're not entirely reliant on Elastic Ooze. They have a number of ways to get up to that center point, plus they have the hidden spring. But they're going to contest it anyway. There's no reason not to. They don't want to do an E rush because I think it would be too easy for ETA to just rotate back over and then they'd be giving up D, not something they want to do. So right now, HK, I don't think, is in the position where he wants to be. ETA, also, they are forced to back up a little bit. This is really just how the fight goes. It's unfortunate that this camera angle doesn't let us see everything that happened, but Wu being able to get in the back here is really strong. Beckett was pushed out early. That's a lot of DPS gone, but this is still risky. Poco is high health, but all of the people in the back for ApeX are fairly low health, and you have double assassin on ETA. But they're still going in. They're still confident. D isn't summoned. I think it just summoned right here, but now they're able to turn around and kill it really quick. I think as soon as ApeX realized that ETA was summoning D, and they knew they could kill it, and they saw that Trip was going for C, they were willing to let C go because they knew that they could kill the creature, win the ensuing fight, and they knew that the power orb wasn't going to be summoning for a little while, so they could safely just take the fight around D, win that, get the creature, summon something there, then rotate back and take the orb at C. Even though ETA are going to try to fight it, they're not going to be able to stop it, I don't think, not with Poco there. So right now, all they have to do is capture this orb. they're playing defensively. They don't want to get too aggressive because they recognize that if they can just push him out, they can grab the orb and they're good, especially now that it's 90 power. There's no reason to risk it. That was a really nice interrupt. But it's really just buying time. It's not going to stop anything. I don't think Trip's in a position to really get any kills, so it's just being obnoxious, but it was sort of a feint. ApeX doesn't care that much about it. So that is going to be first push for ApeX, and it's a really fast push, all things considered. That was a lot of kills going down. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. So they want the shield. That's why they're going for this creature. They're going to get the Cerberus, so that's 100 shield. That means that if ApeX wants any damage on this wound, they're going to have to commit for it. And I think they want to. They just pile onto it. They move in. They recognize that they can put some damage down on ETA and then go for the wound and potentially turn and fight. But I think they sustain too much damage here. Wu does. He has to get out. Sven takes a little bit of damage. I imagine he used his healing waters during that, so he doesn't have that available. And now Trip wants to hunt people down. It's especially scary because, again, double assassin makes you play a little bit more carefully. But since they lost that Cerberus, they do want to resummon D. They have a Cerberus on C as well. I imagine they're going to be doing a lot of Cerberuses this game. However, they might want a Cyclops on D, specifically to stop HK from getting up to that high point. Because the wall goes up right over at the stairs where the opposing team would be able to get up onto that ledge. And so stopping HK from getting there would be a huge boon. So they go for the engage, they get the grab, they hit Sven, but Wu just takes so much damage, there's nothing he can do about it. Plus, he had poison ticking down. It ends right when he gets out of the fight. So he's going to be able to get in again really soon. What did they did summon a Cerberus on D. Right now, ApeX is mostly worried about rotating. They know that they can out-rotate ETA as long as they have a good handle on where they are. Just because of the nature of their team comp, they have the two team-wide super jumps. Now they're thinking about rotating. This is a really hard spot for ETA. When you're running double assassin, it limits your ability to move in and take points and specifically take fights. You can take points pretty quickly, but you can't really take fights. So what ETA is doing here is they're kind of considering this a wash, I think, like this push. They're not terribly interested in it. They're stacking up on D. They want to try to take the power orb away, but it's being seen immediately. And there's not a whole lot they can do. They actually want to take center. They're trying to feint, I think. That's their best bet, is they feint, they get people from ApeX to come in too early, take some extra damage, and then the assassins go in and clean up. So right now, they've done it to Beckett. Beckett's at half health, and they can't really fight. But they also can't really get up to D. Well, they're trying for it. They move up. It's a Cerberus Majoris, though. It was upgraded, so it has a lot of health. One person gets forced down, and now ETA have got to be thinking, all right, well, we can't get this. We've got to get out. They're just delaying the Cerberus Majoris right now. They know that as soon as this power orb goes the way of ApeX, they can probably get the push. Not necessarily, actually, because ApeX has been holding their focus for fights, and they've been using them for fights. Right now, the only person with any focus saved up is Wu. So D's still getting hit. If they can push them off, they can't, though. Taking away the Cerberus Majoris was huge. I wasn't expecting them to be able to get it, but they pushed in. I think that's really the power of the HK there, pushing itself in. It's a really good combo with Sven, too, because you get the armor break on a number of heroes, and then nobody can step out against HK. They're taking way too much damage. There is only 80 shield on this, too, so ETA are going to get some good damage in. If they want to go for the wound, they can. I feel like ETA have a ton of wiggle room right now, but they're committing for this wound. I don't know if this is the best idea for them, because they're getting shredded here. Like, they sort of kind of started going in, but they didn't fully commit. And now Beckett has focus, Sven has focus, and there's no way they can get this wound. Plus, they're giving up D. They really want to hold D. Like, they would definitely prefer to, because taking it from ApeX is a huge struggle. So ApeX is just going to summon an obelisk. They're not terribly worried about holding it for very long. They just want an edge in case someone tries to move in. HK is going to try to get in position. I'm actually curious to see. Okay, so they summoned it up to a Cerberus Majoris. That's why they're doing it. But ETA make the right move and just move over to C. I think they're willing to sack it. just to get this Cerberus Majoris up, because as soon as it does get up, ETA is going to be almost impossible for them to get anything done. ApeX is going to see where they're moving constantly. ApeX has the better rotations. But they're giving up a lot for this deep point. It's mostly summoned. Now Wu joins the fight. He might be able to pick up a couple of kills. If they can make this even, then that would be huge. Trips coming in to help Sven. I don't think that Wu can get this anymore. Here we go. Now they're making an effort. They recognize they need to kill the Cerberus Majoris. They get it below half. They get it below a quarter, really, but nobody else can move in. Everyone's too low. Beckett's here, but she's running for her life. So she's just going to be out. Wu takes a lot of damage here, but he's also okay. He's so slippery. He's been saving his splash kick. This is one of the first times he's actually used the downward kick on it, just because he wants it for mobility. They just wanted to secure the kill, because they knew if they secured the kill, they would be pretty safe. But they lose Paco. Paco's really important in this, because as soon as Beckett's jump pack is down, as soon as Sven has already burnt his elastic ooze, everyone is so vulnerable. And so Paco is a really important part of the defensive lineup. Wu has some peel. Like, he definitely has some, but not a ton. So to take D, ApeX gave up the next push. Questionable, and then they lose it anyway. ETA have been moving around this map really smart. Even though ApeX should have the better mobility, ETA is making really nice movements, and ApeX is not predicting them terribly well. And ETA is abusing that wonderfully. Plus, they have a bloomer on F. They know that they can go in, they can take out D, they can take some damage. As long as nobody dies, they can get back to the bloomer. So they feel a lot safer getting aggressive into that center point. However, they're not fighting around their bloomer here. So ApeX, honestly, I don't think should be fighting here. But they're getting kills because, look at that bloomer. It's sitting there and doing nothing. Nobody's using it. ETA should be trying to draw the fight over to the bloomer, but they were fighting up on the higher ledge. And so that bloomer was entirely ineffectual the whole time. So ApeX, I think that was a gamble by ApeX. I think in most circumstances, they should have lost that. But because ETA refused to fight around their bloomer and refused to use it, they lost that fight pretty hard. So they're thinking, okay, he was starting to summon a Cyclops. I think they recognize that they want to start camping D more. They want to hold this point, and a Cyclops is going to help them a lot. It's going to put up that wall, like I said earlier, up at the bottom of those stairs. It's going to keep HK from getting in the position where he really wants to be. Up to this point, ApeX has been using a lot of their focus to try to upgrade D point, and they haven't gotten anything from it. So now, if they can just manage to hold it now with this Cyclops, they'll be in a better position, I think. So now Wu is behind the enemy team. ETA has moved in incredibly aggressively, but now they're on the low ground. They're hitting the Cyclops. They're stuck between a ledge and a creature. That's not where they want to be. They managed to get Beckett, but they've put themselves in a compromising position. But they're still able to get out. Their movement has been... Okay, not everyone. They're losing HK for this. And that's not what they want at all. They still managed to get the kill. They know they have the upgraded point at E. And as long as that creature is allowed to capture the orb, they'll get the push again. And that's three pushes in a row going the way of ETA. Unless something can happen. I don't think they can. Everyone is too low. People are still moving back in. Sven is moving back in. He just respawned. So the best thing that ApeX can do right now, I think, is just get 100 shield. They don't want to lose anything on the second moon. We're getting to the point where Clash is going to be happening soon. So ApeX are forced out. They're right now, I feel like they're a little bit desperate. The team is moving into positions where they really don't want to be. They're fighting underneath an enemy creature. It's a Cerberus Majoris, yeah, so it's not a ton of healing or anything, but it's still a safe spot where ETA can retreat. Only now are they actually upgrading one of their backline creatures. They recognize that Clash is coming up soon, and so they want to make sure they have at least some creatures, but that means that they're sacrificing a lot of focus. Right now, the only person with focus on ApeX is Voden. It's a powerful focus, to be sure, and the team can take advantage of it, what with Sven's AoE. Beckett has a little bit of AoE as well, so does Paco. I don't know if Paco went for the snowball. If he did, then Voden's focus will be a lot more powerful. Right now, they're just hanging out in the center. They don't want to actually move up on D. They're in center because they want to watch the rotations of ETA. If they rotate into D, they can immediately move up to defend it. Plus, they're all going to be funneled down in the lower area. So defending it is going to be much, much easier. I think if they'd have summoned a Cyclops earlier, they wouldn't have lost so many pushes. But they recognize it now, and it's still even. Like, don't get me wrong, ApeX is definitely still ahead, even though they lost the last three pushes. And this is a huge grab. 12 seconds on the tongue lashing. And now Wu is not going to be able to do a whole lot. The Bloomer is back there. It's going to go offline for a minute to grab the orb. And so they're actually backing up into this tunnel. That's not where you want to be. That's where that little tunnel is where Paco excels because of his breath, his frost breath. And now you have two melee just hammering away. But geez, the AoE is huge. Wu is forced back a lot when they get into those melee brawls. And so it's just going to be one for one. Another tongue lashing. I'm not sure how I feel about that. The tongue lashings are being used incredibly aggressively, but not necessarily effectively. Like, they're getting good damage off. But now he can't go in for a grab on anyone, and ETA feels a lot safer moving together. And ApeX just has to back off. Yeah, now they're all moving in. Again, they have that elastic ooze, so they're fine. And ApeX again is pushed off of D. This is really painful. Or are they? They managed to take it back just barely, but no kills. That was really bold of ETA. Oh, they put a lot of damage on the creature, and they're forcing ApeX to upgrade. I think they wanted to do it anyway, though, because Clash is coming after this push. They definitely want the Cyclops there anyway. An upgraded Cyclops is going to be almost impossible to take during Clash. It'll contribute so much damage if ETA try to fight in there. And now ApeX trying to fight over the Bloomer, but it's taken so much damage. ETA have done a good job of focusing on objectives and swapping between the enemy team and objectives, but here they just commit a little bit too hard. I bet there's almost no health on that Bloomer. I didn't quite spot it. But that means that it's going to be very vulnerable going into Clash. It might be okay. Still, though, ApeX has a huge opportunity here. Three people have dropped. People are going to be respawning in only after the Guardian gets pinned. If any more kills go their way, yeah. So ApeX is going to burn, Rezo is going to burn his focus to take down Wu, just to extend that death timer and give them a little bit more time to escape. Don't know why he jumped there. That's just going to waste time. But they get the wound either way. Now everyone is respawning. So everyone on ApeX is running down through that tunnel. I think it's because they know Paco has the frost breath. And they know that they can get out that way if they take it. But they're actually stopping and turning. I'm not sure this is a great idea because ApeX has no focus. They had no focus going into that fight. And they decided to fight it anyway. They've lost two. It's a two for one right now. Wu is left. He's at high health, but if his team isn't there, he can't really get anything done against more people. And there we go. They lose Voden as well. So that's a three for one going into Clash. That's not how you want to start it, especially with... and they did lose their Bloomer. They did rotate over to C. They took it before the wound ended. I would have waited, but they chose just to take it down and get out of there as quickly as possible. Now the Cyclops is fighting. Again, ETA playing very, very objective base gaming, and it's doing them well, even though they're down a wound. But here comes the rest of ApeX. There's no real way to heal that Cyclops very well for ApeX. They don't have a Vedasi. Sven went for the cleanse on his healing salve. He wants to hold on to it for team fights, especially since ETA seems so team fight happy and rotate heavy. ETA is forcing fights. Like, look at this. Now they're going for the Bloomer. The rotations have been gorgeous this game, but the response from ApeX has been really strong too. HK has gone almost entirely unchecked this game. Through most of the fights, he's able to get his damage down as he wants. Now the orb is there. If ETA can just get one more kill, then they'll have almost no shield on ApeX, and that's a ton of damage on the second wound. But the pressure is still on ETA. Now they're losing people. Like, even though they lost the push, they're losing people. ApeX might go for E here. They have an opening. That's four people dead for 10 seconds. If they can kill this Wu, that's going to be a huge death timer, but he has Splash Kick. He's out. I don't think that... Oh, no, they got him. Paco had plenty of stamina to close distance. That's now they have 8 seconds left. They're just going to go for the Young Bloomer and call it a day. They're not able to get all the shield that they want. Like, that 100 shield would have been really wonderful. But that's okay. They still control D. Like, at the end of the day, ApeX is still well ahead. It's been a very close game, and it's looked very close, but ApeX have... Like, they almost lost control a couple of times. They've desperately clawed to hold on to that center point, but ETA hasn't quite been able to find the openings they want, despite their beautiful rotations. Now, HK, this is one of the first times that HK has been on the defensive so hard, and they still lose him, with everyone trying to keep him alive. And that meant that during the fight, those people trying to defend him weren't getting anything done, and they're on the retreat now. There's no C. There's no B point. They managed to resummon C. Look at this. They're just setting up Cyclopses everywhere. They recognize they need to limit the movement of ETA. They cannot allow them to move the way they have been. And I think that since the map is so small now, they don't need Cerberuses. They don't need that early warning. They can just see. They can use Wu essentially to scout. That's probably what he's going to be doing now. That's why he's moving around the center. He's not really looking for openings. He's just trying to keep an eye on them, figure out where they are. There goes the Cyclops. So right now, power is really even. ApeX definitely has a lead. So ETA, again, is forced on the offensive. ETA don't want to be this offensive this game. They want to harass. They want to peck at people. They want to get them low so Trip can go in and Wu can go in and get a quick kill. They probably want Wu and Trip running together. So ETA haven't been able to play the game that they want to at all, and that's because of how ApeX has been playing. That's why they've been playing so hard for the center point, is they recognize that they can't play ETA's game. And it cost them 3 pushes, but it's still given them the momentum that they need to take this game back in Clash and have that center point when they need it. So Trip, I think that this kind of desperation is showing right now, because Trip was moving in, trying to find an opening, and actually was fighting Wu, was fighting Rezo. That's not what a Trip wants to be doing. Trip usually doesn't want to be in a one-on-one fight unless it's with a DPS or like a ranged DPS. ApeX's teamfight is also very strong in the Clash. Voden has the right range for it. Beckett has the right range for it. Paco can do really well down in the icicles in the center, in those cold rocks just beneath the center point. He does really well there. Where HK struggles a little bit. He struggles to get the damage down and chase the way he wants to. And now ApeX, everyone's up. They're really comfortable with this. This is probably going to be them closing out the game. They have the armor crack from Sven, and this is just way too much damage for them to be able to handle. No one on ApeX has died. Really, really clean game, like, around the end. Definitely not the whole time, but what are Wu's gauntlets doing? I was unhappy.